Hi students, now in this video we are going to discuss about logarithmic test. First, let us see what is the statement of this test. After that, we will see when it is used, and also we will see one example. Here, the statement of this test is, write down, if summation an is positive term series, such that L is equal to limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1, then first one, summation an is convergent if L greater than 1, second one, summation an is divergent if L less than 1, third one, test fails if L is equal to 1. Here summation an is positive term series, and also L, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1. Then what happened? Now let us see. If L greater than 1, then we can say that the series, that is summation an, is convergent. Okay. If L less than 1, then we can say that the given series, that is summation an, is divergent. If L is equal to 1, then test fails. That means in this case, logarithmic test fail. So here we have to find the value of L, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1. So here in this logarithmic test, what is the L value? What is L? Limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1. What is L here? Limit n tends to infinity of n of, limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1. Okay, here limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1 can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity of log of an by an plus 1. So here limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1 can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity of log of an by an plus 1. No problem. Okay. Here limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1 can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity of log of an by an plus 1. Now let us see when to use this test. That means when we will apply the logarithmic test. Okay, now let us see when it is used. Okay, here if the ratio test fails, here If the ratio test fails to test the convergence or divergence of the given series, and also the ratio, that is an by an plus 1 or an plus by an, involves the number e, then only we will use the logarithmic test. Okay, once again I will explain when we will apply the logarithmic test. If the ratio test fails to test the convergence or divergence of the given series, okay, and also the ratio, that is an by an plus 1 or an plus 1 by an, involves the number e, then only we will use logarithmic test. Okay, if the ratio test fails to test the convergence or divergence of the given series, and also the ratio, that is an by an plus 1 or an plus 1 by an, involve the number e, then only we will use logarithmic test. Okay, write down note. The test is applied after the failure of the ratio test, and generally when in the ratio an plus 1 by an or an by an plus 1, as you are like, involve the number e, the test is applied after the failure of ratio test, and generally when in the ratio, that is an plus 1 by an or an by an plus 1, involve the number e. Okay. Now let us see one example. Okay, write down. Test the convergence of the series summation n is equal to 0 to infinity n power n x power n by n factorial. Okay, test the convergence of the series summation n is equal to 0 to infinity n power n x power n by n factorial. Okay, first let us consider the given series as summation an. Okay, therefore an will be equal to 2 n power n x power n by n factorial. Okay, first let us use ratio test for whether the given series is convergent or divergent. So first let us use ratio test, okay, for checking the given series is, for whether the given series is convergent or divergent. So first let us use ratio test for whether the given series is convergent or divergent. Okay, so first we have to find an plus 1. Tell me an plus 1 directly. N plus 1 whole power n x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial. Okay, please listen carefully. Okay, now an plus 1 whole power n into x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 factorial can be written as n plus 1 whole power n plus 1 into x power n into x by n plus 1 factorial can be written as n plus 1 n factorial. So here n plus 1 n plus 1 get cancelled. So finally we get n plus 1 whole power n x power n into x by n factorial. After that we have to find L value. That means L is equal to limit n tends to infinity a n plus 1 by a n, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity a n plus 1 is nothing but n plus 1 whole power n, okay, x power n into x by n factorial by a n is nothing but n factorial by n power n into x power n. Here n power n, here x power n get cancelled, n factorial get cancelled, okay. So here we get limit n tends to infinity, okay, n plus 1 whole power n by n power n can be written as n plus 1 by n whole power n into x. N plus 1 whole power n by n power n can be written as n plus 1 by n whole power n, okay. So remaining term which is x, okay. Now let us apply limit n tends to infinity here, or limit n tends to infinity n plus 1 by n whole power n can be written as limit n tends to infinity of. So here by taking n as a common factor from numerator, so here we get n of 1 plus 1 by n whole power n into x. So here n n get cancelled. So now this can be written as x into limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. So now which is equal to x, already we know that limit n tends to infinity of 1 plus 1 by n whole power n is nothing but what? E. So that is the formula. Okay. Therefore, L is equal to x E. So, by ratio test, we have this series, that is summation an is convergent if L less than 1. That means summation an is convergent if what is L? Xe less than 1. Therefore, the given series, that is summation an is convergent if x less than 1 by e. Therefore, the given series, that is summation an, is convergent if x less than 1 by e. Similarly, summation an is divergent if L greater than 1 by ratio test. Okay. Therefore, summation an is divergent if xe greater than 1. Therefore, summation an is divergent if x greater than 1 by e. Okay. And also here ratio test fails if L is equal to 1. What is L here? X is equal to 1. Therefore, x is equal to 1 by e. Therefore, at x is equal to 1 by e, the ratio test is fail. Okay. If you observe that here clearly, so here we have what we have? We have a n plus 1 by a n is nothing but n plus 1 by n whole power n into x. Okay. Already we know that a n plus 1 by a n is nothing but n plus 1 by n whole power n into x. Okay. At x is equal to 1 by E, at x is equal to 1 by E, An plus 1 by An is equal to N plus 1 by N whole power N into 1 by E. Hello, at x is equal to 1 by E, An plus 1 by An is nothing but N plus 1 by whole power N 1 by E. You observe that here ratio test fails at x is equal to 1 by E. Okay, and also at x is equal to 1 by E, the ratio, that is An plus 1 by An, involve the number E. You observe that here, first of all, ratio test fail at x is equal to 1 by E. And also at x is equal to 1 by E, the ratio An plus 1 by An involve the number E. Already we know that if ratio test fails and also ratio involves the number E, then only we will use logarithmic test. If ratio test fails and the ratio involves the number E, then we are using logarithmic test. So let us use logarithmic test at x is equal to 1 by E only. Now let us use logarithmic test at x is equal to 1 by E only. Okay. Please listen carefully. Here we have An plus 1 by An is equal to N plus 1 by N whole power N into 1 by E. Already we know that An plus 1 by An is equal to N plus 1 by N whole power N into 1 by E. So here N plus 1 by N whole power N can be written as N plus 1 whole power N in by N power N into 1 by E. Okay. Now tell me what is An by An plus 1. So here An by An plus 1 will be equal to N power N by N plus 1 whole power N into E. Because already we know that An plus 1 by An is nothing but N plus 1 whole power N by N power N into 1 by E. Therefore, An by An plus 1 is equal to N power N by N plus 1 whole power N into E. Okay. For any doubt, please check it. Okay. Don't worry. Okay. Now, this can be written as N by N plus 1 whole power N into E. Okay. Now let us use logarithmic test. In logarithmic test, what is L? So L is equal to limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1. Okay. Now which is equal to, listen carefully, very tough problem. Limit n tends to infinity of n into log of an by an plus 1 is nothing but n by n plus 1 whole power n into E. Okay, n into log of an by an plus 1 is nothing but n by n plus 1 whole power n into E. Okay, log of n by n plus 1 whole power n into E. Okay, clear? Now, which is equal to limit n tends to infinity of n into, so here log of n by n plus 1 whole power n into E can be written as log of n by n plus 1 whole power n plus log E. See here, log of n by n plus 1 whole power n into e can be written as log of n by n plus 1 whole power n plus log e, because here I am using formula log of ab. Log of ab is equal to log a plus log b. Log a plus log b. Log of a b is nothing but log a plus log b. Okay, clear? Now here limit of n of this term can be written as n into limit of n tends to infinity of log of n by n plus 1 whole power n plus log is nothing but 1. Log is nothing but 1. Okay. And now this can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity, okay, n tends to infinity of log of n by n plus 1 can be written as 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole power n plus 1. Log of n by n plus 1 whole power n can be written as log of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. Okay, see here n by, here I am taking n as a common factor in denominator, so here we get n of 1 plus 1 by n get cancelled, so here we get log of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n. Okay, so here I am taking n as a common factor in denominator. So here we get n of 1 plus 1 by n. Nn get cancelled. So finally we get log of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole power n. Okay. Now L is equal n into limit n tends to infinity of log of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole power n can be written as 1 plus 1 by n whole power minus n plus 1. Any problem? Log of 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole power n can be written as log of 1 plus 1 by n whole power minus n. Okay. Plus 1. Now, which is equal to n into limit n tends to infinity of log of 1 plus 1 by n whole power minus n can be written as minus n into log of 1 plus 1 by n plus 1. So now this can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity of 1 minus n into log of 1 plus 1 by n. Okay. Now here for writing log of 1 plus 1 by n, so here I am using formula. Write down formula. What is the formula? Log of 1 plus x. Log of 1 plus x is equal to x minus x square by 2 plus x cube by 3 minus x power 4 by 4 plus so on. Okay. So here for writing log of 1 plus 1 by n, so here I am using formula, that is log of 1 plus x. Okay, just you have to substitute x with 1 by n here. So here we get log of 1 plus 1 by n. Okay, so now which is equal to n into limit n tends to infinity of 1 minus n into log of 1 plus 1 by n. Tell me log of 1 plus 1 by n. Just you have to substitute x with 1 by n here. So here we get 1 by n minus 1 by n square by 2 is nothing but 1 by 2n square. Just you have to substitute x with 1 by n here. So here we get x is equal to 1 by n minus x square is nothing but 1 by n whole square is nothing but 1 by n square by 2 is nothing but 1 by 2n square plus x with 1 by n. 1 by n cube is nothing but 1 by 3n cube minus 1 by 4 n power 4 plus so on. Okay, just we have to substitute x with 1 by n here. we get log of 1 plus 1 by n. Okay, now which is equal to n into limit n tends to infinity of 1 minus, so here multiply n with this term. Okay, by multiplying this term with n, so here we get 1. Okay, n by n is nothing but 1 minus n by 2n square is nothing but 1 by 2n plus 1 by 3n square minus 1 by 4n cube. Okay, so on. Okay. Okay, so now this can be written as n into limit n tends to infinity of 1 minus 1 plus 1 by 2n minus 1 by 3n square plus 1 by 4n cube, so on. Okay, minus of this term is nothing but minus 1 plus 1 by 2n minus 1 by 3n square plus 1 by 4n cube. Okay, so here 1 get cancelled. Okay, so here we get L is equal to n into limit n tends to infinity of 1 by 2n minus 1 by 3n plus 1 by 3, 4n cube, so on. Okay, now this can be written as limit n tends to infinity of n of 1 by 2n minus 1 by, sorry, 3n square plus 1 by 4n cube, so on. Okay, so this can be written as limit n tends to infinity of n into 1 by 2n minus 1 by 3n square plus 1 by 4n cube, so on. Okay, so now limit n tends to infinity of n into 1 by 2n is nothing but 1 by 2 minus n into 1 by 3n square is nothing but 1 by 3n plus n into 1 by 4n cube is nothing but 1 by 4n square, so on. Okay, now let us apply limit n tends to infinity. So here we get 1 by 2 minus 1 by infinity plus 1 by infinity. 1 by 3 into infinity is nothing but 1 by infinity. Okay, plus so on. So here 1 by 2 minus 0 plus 0 is nothing but 1 by 2. So here we can see that L, which is equal to 1 by 2, which is also less than 1. Already we know that if L less than 1, then the given series is divergent by logarithmic test. So here we can see that L is equal to 1 by 2, which is less than 1. So by LT means logarithmic test, we have the series summation an is divergent eto x is equal to 1 by a. So here the answer is, final answer is, what is the final answer? The given series summation an is convergent if x less than 1 by a, divergent if x greater than 1 by e. Okay, please practice this problem, very very important. Okay student, okay students, write down formula log of 1 minus x minus of x plus x square by 2 plus x cube by 3 plus x power 4 by 4 plus, so on. Okay, so this is the formula, remember that formula. Okay, very very important. Now I will give you some problems, please do it. Okay, first one, test to the convergence of the following series. First one, 1 plus x by 2 plus 2 factorial by 3 square x square plus 3 factorial by 4 cube x cube plus, so on. Okay, test to the convergence of the following series using only logarithmic test. test. So here in this problem I will give you nth term. What is the nth term? N factorial by n plus 1 whole power n x power n. Okay, answer is, what is the answer? Convergent if e greater than x, divergent if e less than or equal to x. Second one, 1 plus 2x by 2 factorial plus 3 square x square by 3 factorial plus 4 cube x cube by 4 factorial plus so on. So here x greater than 0. Answer, what is the answer? Convergent if x less than 1 by e. Okay. Divergent if x greater than 1 by e. Okay. Please do it. These problems very, very important. Okay.